Namaskar and welcome to In Samachar. Today we'll talk about education amid COVID-19 pandemic. The UNESCO will convene an extraordinary session of Global Education Meeting, also known as GEM, next month for exchange among high-level political leaders, policymakers, and global education experts to protect and rethink education in current and post-COVID-19 world. The United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization session on October 22 is convened with an aim to protect and promote education at a time when education financing is at considerable risk of being left behind in governments' domestic budgets, stimulus packages and international aid. The UN agency said by convening this extraordinary session of GEM next month, our aim is to secure commitments from political leaders to position education at a center of national and international efforts to recover swiftly, inclusively and sustainably from COVID-19 pandemic, said Stefana Giannini, Assistant Director of Education at UNESCO. Giannini said the overreaching concern is to at least maintain, if not increase, educational financing to avoid a generational catastrophe. We need a more integrated, influential and accountable coordination system for education, entirely geared to build back better through stronger links between policy steering and finance. It is precisely in the spirit that this 2020 GEM will also launch an inclusive consultation on roadmap for the improvement of global SDG 4 Education 2030 coordination mechanism. Among the themes outlined for the session are protecting domestic and international financing of education, reopening schools safely, focusing on inclusion, equity and gender equality, reimagining teaching and learning, harnessing equitable connectivity and technology for learning. Behind the 2020 GEM is to resolve to speak with one voice against the backdrop of unprecedented disruption that requires us to be disruptive in how we act. The GEM is driven by this sense of urgency. It pulls the alarm on dramatic consequences that any decline in aid and national budgets will have on an already deep education crisis. According to UNESCO estimates, over 154 crore students are severely impacted by the closure of educational institutions across the world amid the COVID-19 outbreak. And agencies like UNESCO, UNICEF, along with World Bank and World Food Programme have recently come up with guidelines on how to safely reopen schools in the wake of COVID-19 and also warned that widespread closure of educational facilities present an unprecedented risk to children's education and well-being. That's all for today. For more such news updates, log on to www.insamachar.com. This is Anshi Srivastav signing off. Namaskar.